Now, the Philippines identifies at least 44 close contacts of the country's first case of the Omicron BA.2.12 subvariant. Some of them already tested negative for COVID, while others are being monitored by the health department.
We all know that there is this 14 days incubation period of the virus. So if we consider that 14 days, we can also be thinking that she might have gotten that during her travel. Because she arrived here on April 2, she had her symptoms on April 10, and that would be the 9th day of her infection. So we got the manifesto already from the airplane. We had our contact tracing already. She had a total of 30 close contacts, near contacts in the airplane. We were able to try to see the vaccination status of these contacts, and most of them are fully vaccinated. Some of them were tested and it turned out to be negative. All of them are being closely monitored and nobody is experiencing symptoms as of this time.
The first Omicron subvariant case was a woman from Finland who arrived in Manila on April 2nd. She was not required to undergo facility quarantine since she was fully vaccinated and arrived asymptomatic. She then traveled to Quezon City and Benguet before experiencing mild symptoms. She has since recovered and had returned to Finland. The Philippine Health Department says the new sublineage of the Omicron variant is over 2 times more transmissible than the original Omicron strain. But the agency asserts getting vaccinated and following safety protocols are still effective in controlling the spread of the virus. It adds the sublineage is not yet considered a variant of interest or a variant of concern.
Based on studies and based from the experts across the globe and WHO, BA.2.12, which is now affecting the United States, 93% of their new infections are comprised of this BA.2.12. This is 2.5 times more transmissible than the original Omicron variant.
A former COVID-19 task force advisor, meanwhile, urges government to start administering second COVID-19 booster shots to more sectors amid the threat of the new subvariant. The Philippine government has begun rolling out the additional jabs to the immunocompromised, but it's still reviewing its efficacy on senior citizens and health workers.
The immunodeficient are apt to be very small in number. So it would include patients who are with HIV, kidney transplant patients, bedridden patients, ongoing cancer. And these are the patients who are very difficult to find and to push to the vaccination centers. So what I would do based on the US FDA and the local FDA is, of course, to fast track the vaccination and the booster for the healthcare workers, that's the A1, the A2, the senior citizen, and lump the immunodeficient symptoms with the comorbid conditions, that's A3.